der Kiefer vor. Halleluja, halleluja, hat noch Holz zu wilden. Let's all sing once again. Oh Lord, lift up your two hands, let's sing together.
Yeah, yeah.
Jesus, thank you, Lord, that every agenda of the enemy is destroyed. Masom mekatiri anda, sebre demenekatori, sebre dole malivorondi kabara. In the name of Jesus, we thank you. Thank you for what you're about to do, and for what you're about to will go on to see. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
A round of applause to the name of the Lord. Are you clapping unto any man?
Hallelujah!
I said unto the name of the Most High. Unto the name of the Most High. Unto the name of the Most High. Hallelujah! Tell somebody, don't be absent-minded. Tell somebody for me. Tell somebody, don't be absent-minded. Hallelujah! It's a trick of the enemy to be absent-minded. Amen. Shake somebody and tell that person we're moving forward. Tell somebody we are moving forward. Hallelujah. Ask somebody, are you here in the room? Be here till we close. Take your seats. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord.
My God.
Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. I want to see you. I want to see you.
now we begin.
Open, open,
open the eyes of my heart.
Open the eyes of my eyes, Lord.
Open the eyes of my heart.
I want to see.
I want to see
you. Hallelujah.
I want to see.
I want to encourage somebody on what I've captioned. The Mephibosheth blessing.
Hallelujah.
Can you say after me? Mephibosheth. The Mephibosheth blessing.
The Mephibosheth.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
And it's my prayer that before you leave this place, you'll be encouraged. You will be challenged, you'll be moved. And you will dare to go for it. In the name of Jesus. And you will desire to pray and pray earnestly for it. Amen. I'm reading verse 4 of chapter 4 of 2 Samuel.
Take some of fear. Verse 4.
Chapter 4, verse 4. Oh, really, where's your Bible? Sit properly like you are in church. And Jonathan saw Sam had a son. And Jonathan saw Sam had a son. I hope it's explained. Jonathan was the son of Saul.
Jonathan
had a son. Amen. So Saul's son is called Jonathan. We're going to talk about Jonathan's son. Amen. That was lame of his feet. He was 5 years old when the tidings came of Saul and Jonathan out of Jezreel. And his nurse took him up and fled. And it came to pass, as she made haste to flee, that he fell and became lame. And his name was Mephibosheth. Hallelujah. Jonathan and his father Saul, as a result of his father's disobedience, that is Saul, he lost the kingdom, he lost the kingship, he lost the right to rule Israel. You know, Saul was the first king of Israel. And as a result of his disobedience, God denied him and took the rulership, the kingship from his family and decided to give it out to somebody else. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he kept being disobedient. And so there was serious punishment such that he was wiped out of the scene together with his children and some of his family. The Bible says that when war broke up out of Jezreel, by then Mephibosheth was 5 years old. And when it happened that way, there was a nurse. Because you know war, when it happens that way, everybody run for their life. I am telling you, far be it from us. Right now, if something happens and we hear loud noise and the room is shaking and things are turning upside down and you see gun and you see death, I am sure you will forget your name. Hallelujah. That is where you see sick people running for their lives. And sometimes those who are even sick, those who feel they cannot walk, those who feel they have pains in their legs, they run faster. Hallelujah. And so, when it happened that way, everybody was running for their lives, everybody was running for safety. And the nurse who was taking care of Mephibosheth took Mephibosheth. And as a result of running, because you have to run and save life, save your life and save the life of a child, Mephibosheth fell from the hands of the nurse and he broke his legs. And Mephibosheth became lame. Hallelujah. He became lame for life. He became lame and his father died and his grandfather died and the kingship was taken from their house. So you can imagine the plight of Mephibosheth. Somebody who was born in how do you call it, a royal home. Somebody who had a nurse who was taking care of him. I am sure the moment he does, oh, I like cookies, they provide. I want cake, he will provide. Am I telling lies? You know what happens in royal homes? Amen.
Amen.
Some of you, you buy dresses for your children when it's only time for a special occasion. Am I telling lies?
No.
Especially Africans. If it's not Christmas, no new dress. Oh, am I telling lies? When it's Christmas,
Amen.
Amen. I remember very well my father. He keeps telling us, when is your birthday? And you go to him, this guy is coming from, or he was born in a royal home. Well, when he grew, they will ask him what is wrong. You go to the best daycare. They will give him the best milk, best food, best dress.
Beste kleding.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the unexpected happened.
Het onverwachte gebeurde.
His daddy died, his grandfather died, everybody died, and so he was left. What? And left alone.
Dus hij was kreupelen alleen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say hallelujah.
Amen.
I didn't say amen. Listen amen. To me. I said say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh. And one day, say one day. Go to 2 Kings chapter 9. I'm cutting my story short.
I'm off how court.
One day, Mephibosheth was minding his business. He forgot the glory he enjoyed when he was young. And was eating his watch like that. And his banku without fish. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Did I say 2 Kings?
Yeah.
Sorry, 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel. The story continues. 2 Samuel. 2 Samuel chapter 4, 2 Samuel chapter 9. From verse 1. Hallelujah. So Mephibosheth was, I don't know whether he was a farmer or he was a fisherman. I don't know his profession. But well, he kept on doing what he was doing. Mephibosheth have grown. I am sure Mephibosheth have forgotten that something good will ever happen to him. But one day, one day, say one day. If God wants to bless you and want to change your destiny, it doesn't take years. It doesn't take what? Years. It doesn't take months. Hallelujah. Some of you, when you consider your state, and God even tells you or speaks to your spirit that I can bless you, I can change your destiny. And you look at the way you have toiled and struggled for years and you didn't get anything. You think it will take 10 years. You think it will take 20 years for God to change your destiny. But God sent me as a prophet this evening to come and tell somebody that God is about to change your story. God is about to change your destiny. God is about to bless you. And it's not going to take many days. It's not going to take years. It's not going to take weeks. It's going to take just one day.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. One day. Bible says, and David said from verse 1, is there yet any that is left in the house of Saul that I may show him kindness for Jonathan's sake? Just one day. Hallelujah. Then God put into the heart of David. And I came to tell somebody that this evening, God is going to open the windows of heaven.
Oh my God.
And he's going to pour somebody the blessings of Mephibosheth. You know the blessings of Mephibosheth? God put Mephibosheth in the heart of somebody who is in authority. God put Mephibosheth in the heart of somebody who has power, who has authority to help you. God put Mephibosheth in the heart of somebody who have the key to open that door and give you breakthrough. And this evening I came to announce, I came to prophesy that God will put you in the heart of somebody, somebody who don't know you, somebody who don't know your name, somebody who have never met you before, somebody who don't know you anywhere. He is going to favor you, he is going to think about you, and he is going to help you.
Amen. It's a confirmation.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
David said, is there anybody? That means David didn't know about Mephibosheth. He didn't know Mephibosheth was struggling somewhere. He didn't know Mephibosheth who was lame and he was struggling from hand to mouth.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But God, 10 tables. Just one day, David asked,
David,
is there anybody in the house of Saul that I can show some kindness for the sake of Jonathan? Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Lift up your right hand. Say, it is going to be my story.
It is going to
say,
be my
it is my story.
It is my story.
Say, it is my story.
It is my story.
Say, I am moving.
I am moving.
And I am going to experience,
and I'm going to experience
the blessings
of Mephibosheth.
In Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Is there anybody? Meaning David didn't know about Mephibosheth. So as he was asking, same way, God will call somebody who has to just write and sign and say yes and say positive and say take it and say I cancel the debt and say I am giving you the money and say this and they say that. That which will help you, that which will move you forward. May God cause that person to walk stand in for you in the name of Jesus.
My God. One day.
Just one day.
One day.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Let's read verse 2. How I wish I have time. Today I want us to pray, so I'll cut something short. And I'm sure another time I'll visit this same message. And there was on the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. You know, when God wants to bless you, he knows how to connect. Say connect.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He knows how to arrange and connect. Hallelujah.
That's right.
There was somebody in the house of Saul who was still in the house of David. Everybody was wiped away, but Ziba was still there.
Amen.
Because God knew he would use Ziba to talk for Mephibosheth. And when they had called him unto David, the king said unto him, art thou Ziba? And he said, yes, I am. Let's read on. Be fast. And the king said, is there not yet any of the house of Saul that I may show him the kindness of God unto him? And Ziba said unto the king, Jonathan had yet a son, which is lame of his feet.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Everybody have forgotten. Nobody even remember. But God who knows, he says, I have engraved you in the palms of my hand. I will never forget you. Your prayers are always before me. I am praying that Jehovah will open the windows of heaven and cause somebody to remember. Put you in the heart of somebody. Put you in the mind of somebody. Let somebody think about you. Somebody who can help you. Somebody who can change your life, somebody who can change your situation, somebody in authority, somebody who has power to remember and talk for you.
For you to speak.
Let's go on. And the king said unto him, where is he? And Ziba said unto the king, behold, he is in the house of Makir, the son of Amiel, in Lodibar. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the king asked, look, this scripture, I wish I would have connected it to Daniel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Daniel chapter 6, when Daniel was put in the lion's den. But no time, let me finish this and then we pray. The same way the king couldn't sleep. He spent the night because of Daniel, waiting that day will break for him to find out. If God is ready for you, and he says he's prepared for you, kings will stay awake.
Hey!
Oh, you don't understand.
Amen.
When God is prepared to bless you,
my God.
People in authority will carry your back and help you.
Hey!
That is what I am talking about.
I am the one. Hey.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me move. Then King David sent and fetched him out of the house of Makir. Where you live, whether it's very far or not, it's not going to be an obstacle.
It is an obstacle.
Distance don't matter if God is ready to bless you. He sent and they fetched him and they brought him out of the house of Makir, the son of Amnon from Lodibar. Let's read on. Now when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, was come unto David, he fell on his face and did reverence. And David said, Mephibosheth, and he answered, behold thy servant. Let me read very fast. And David said unto him, fear not, for I will surely show thee kindness for Jonathan thy father's sake, and I will restore thee all the land of Saul. Say restore.
Restore.
Say restore.
Restore.
Say restore.
Restore.
Say restore.
Restore.
So when God is ready to hand over the blessings of Mephibosheth unto you, definitely there will surely be a restoration.
Prophesy, prophesy.
He says, I will restore all.
Yes.
I will restore thee all the land of Saul, thy father, and thou shalt eat bread from my table continually. This message is not for this evening. It should be on a Sunday when I will have time to take my time and break it in detail and digest it so you can chew it for it to enter into your bloodstream. This evening I want to rush. I'm rushing. But I wish I have time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, I will restore all the land of your grandfather.
Amen.
Oh, I am going to give to you that which belongs to your grandfather. That which your grandfather should have used, that he couldn't use. That which he should have handed over to your father, and your father missed it. You are going to carry that blessing in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say promotion.
Promotion.
So number three, promotion. Blessings of Mephibosheth. You will eat from my table. You will eat from the king's table. Your status is changing.
It's changing.
Your status is going to change. This message, it takes people who have faith to believe it.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. When you get some of these blessings, that is where you stand and then you ask yourself, who am I?
Well,
who am I, God? Why are you blessing me like that?
My God.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
sir. Mephibosheth looked at himself. I am sure when he was coming, he was doing
It was his time to start.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He was moving his legs and throwing them because he was lame. I don't know how the lame people work. Somebody, some people, they know how to do it very well. The way can do it. Amen. And stood before the king. And the king told him, look, I'm changing your status.
Oh my God. Your status.
Wow.
From today, you're going to eat with me.
So to the man of the town,
oh my God. Whoa.
Abba,
my Jesus.
From today, your status is changing.
Oh my goodness,
your status is changing. You are moving from anti-single to anti-married.
Hey!
You are moving to from anti-parent to anti-mother.
Aha!
You are moving from poor to plenty.
Oh,
Jehovah. You are moving from diabetes to good health.
Hallelujah.
The blessings of the Lord,
de zegeningen van de
Heer, it make it rich, and adds no sorrow.
Komt geen droevigheid bij.
He says, I'm from today you are going to eat bread with me.
Maar vandaag zit u aan tafel eten. Voortdurend.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God does not bless, and then you see going up today. Tomorrow you come down.
God zegt u niet dat u nu omhoog gaat.
There's an enemy somewhere.
Dan is er een vijand ergens.
When God is lifting,
wanneer God u ophebt,
like we spoke about Isaac,
he
sowed in the land, and in the same year, he got blessed, he increased, he went forward, he became great, and became very great.
Amen.
That is how God blesses.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's read verse 8. And he bowed himself and said, what is thy servant that thou shouldest look upon such a dead dog as I am?
Oh my God, Jesus Christ.
I am sure when he was going to the king's palace, his dress, when they give it to you, he sat there. You wouldn't like it. So when he looked at himself,
and I came at himself,
he said, hey. Oh. I want an English song. They don't understand the key. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We will get there.
He was asking himself, God, what?
God.
Me?
Waarom?
To eat here.
Here to eat?
For years.
Jarenlang.
I think it was about 40 years when these
God.
Blessings happened to him. So for good 35 years, he was wallowing in poverty.
Had hij armoede.
He has given birth to about 15 children.
Mm-hmm.
You can imagine. The guy was lame, but he wasn't sleeping. Just to make you.